is Robert Dawit. I'm standing on one of many beautiful beaches here on the Gold Coast of Australia. Now, I'm a native Californian, but I recently relocated here so I can enjoy the Australian lifestyle. With my 28 years experience as a professional dog trainer, I was hoping to make a living doing what I love to do in this beautiful country. But first, I need to immerse myself in the culture and learn the Australian way.
By learning to drive on the other side of the road. I've had fun traveling around the country, getting up close and personal with many cute Australian animals. Even the dingoes, who were first introduced to Australia from Southeast Asia around 4,000 years ago, dingoes have wrists that rotate and a head that can turn 180 degrees in each direction. In Australia, it's all about having a beer with your mates. I just need to get used to the way they talk. Very cool accents if you can understand them. Just listen to this bloke.
Just then a paddy wagon came round. This bloke took off like a Bondi tram. Ben Ingham. You should have seen him go like a rat up a drainpipe. I tell you, I had a look at him. He's not the 4 quid. Another bloke standing around. I said, hey, do you know this fella? He said, yeah, he's a real galah.
I've even learned to play the didgeridoo. I'll play more for you later. Now, it hasn't been all fun and travel. I have devoted some time to promoting my business.
I've been meeting pet shop owners and veterinarians in my area, letting them know I'm a dog-friendly dog trainer slash behaviorist, teaching dogs through motivation and achievement rather than dominance or intimidation. I've been visiting Australia's great dog beaches, and I'm learning that Australians highly value referrals they get from friends or other professionals. So the success with my clients' dogs and the trust I'm earning from the veterinarians can be a great way to get work. And lately, things have been picking up.
One of the programs I've offered for years that has proven to be very popular over here is what I like to call Doggy Behavior Makeover Holiday Edition. Before I tell you more about the program, the dog I want you to meet
is Frida, a 4.5-month-old Kelpie mix. The house behind me is where Frida lives, and I'll be staying there a whole month. So while the owners are enjoying their holiday, it's my job to get Frida and others trained and their behavior problems under control before the owner returns. And it makes sense the training is conducted in and around the dog's own environment where the problems are happening. And of course, it's much easier and quicker for me to change the bad behaviors to good ones than it is the owners. The question I get asked the most, other than, do I train children, is will the dog listen to the owner when they return? Well, a blind person doesn't train their seeing eye dog. A professional does the training, then teaches the person how the training is kept up.
Hi, I'm here with Wanda. Wanda is a one-year-old bird.
Hi, I'm here with Lily, and I'm going to teach you.
We're here with Eddie in this incredible
this chance. He's an 8-month-old boxer.
Mojo. Okay, he's here with Scotty.
All right. And I'm here with
I
Wes.
Can help you train.
Walk.
What I want to go.
In addition to the lessons with the owner, I make how-to videos starring their own dog, showing detailed instruction how the training is kept up. I'll use some of the footage to produce other how-to videos for clients, my blog, or YouTube channel. The best part of the program is the dogs don't have to stay at a boarding facility for weeks or staying at a friend's place who aren't 100% devoted to them and, let's face it, end up teaching all the bad habits, not the good ones. They get to travel around, get lots of attention, and learn all sorts of things.
All right. Over the years, I've rehabilitated many dogs. But recently, here in Australia, there's two dogs with a special story. The first one is Frida here, whom you've already met. And I'll have her story later. The second dog is Magic.
We got her at about age 10 weeks and brought her home, and she just seemed to be like really scared right from the word go.
We knew we had a bit of a problem there, so we tried to find somebody that would, address the issues somewhat, and we did find somebody to look at her.
Because with the other lady, she had like 4 one-hour lessons. She hadn't even patted magic yet, and magic would sort of show that bit of fear aggression even towards this other lady.
But what was, I guess, most disheartening for us was that the veterinarian and the trainer were hinting that we possibly, you know, have to look at putting her down. And I ran into Robert from Malibu dog training.
And within, 1 minute flat, Robert had already patted magic. And that was one of our biggest things, where people couldn't even pat magic with this fear aggression that she was showing. Anyone who came close, especially kids, she just would do the whole and even snap at them. We were going away on holiday actually for about 10 days or 12 days. Robert said that he looks after dogs as well, and since we'd already got a huge improvement with Robert, we figured that it would be best if he looked after her in our own home.
Yeah.
That way she'd have all the comforts of home.
Yeah, and as an end result.
How was that? Yeah. Was that a big difference?
Yeah, huge difference. Massive. She's normally pulling my arm out of the socket.
She used to bolt underneath that table at the back. Not the big one, the wooden one. She'd go underneath it.
Oh, because she was
afraid?
She
wouldn't let us touch her.
She wasn't cuddly before when she tried to nip me.
So she's a different dog. She's a dog now that, you know, we would never have to think about putting her down.
And even like when the kids and that come over to our house, because Robert's made lots of friends in the neighbourhood, all the kids, they come over to see Robert now instead of us, don't they? So yeah, they all, you know, and Magic's really happy to see the kids. And then we saw the video and the photo of Magic jumping to hoop. So we definitely know that there's more than just Robert did more than just address the fear aggression. Yeah. He's got it jumping through hoops now.
All right, now's the time for me to play the didgeridoo for you while I tell you more about the area Frida lives in.
The last few jobs have been here in the beautiful town of Byron Bay, located on the most easterly point of Australia, just an hour south from the Gold Coast. It's known for its beautiful coastline and beaches, surfing, music festivals. It's a popular backpacker's destination.
Whatever town I'm in, I expose the dogs to as many sights and sounds as I can. I especially practice the training in and around the places the owners frequent. This helps the dog understand how to behave when the owner returns to these same places.
You wouldn't know it by looking at Frida here, but she was a terror as a puppy. The owner had a lot of control problems until a good Samaritan named Melissa gave her my contact details. I'll let Melissa tell you her story coming up in part 2. Go check it out. Was that a trained cat? Even more reason to go to part 2. Sit. Good. Catch. Good boy.
boy, Chance. Oh, you're such a good boy. Yeah.